Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the basics of SEO, how SEO works and how search engine works actually, and what are the different kinds of SEO techniques we have and algorithms. So everything we're gonna discuss it here. So now let's get started. So everyone might know the abbreviation of this SEO. Can you tell me?
Search engine optimization.
Very good.
Search engine optimization.
Search engine optimization. Manasa,
yeah,
I have a question for you. So now you designed your website, right?
Yeah.
You designed, so everything you are done with, you know, whatever the images you want to upload and whatever the video content, so everything, whatever the content you just wants to showcase in your website, you have done everything. Yeah. So tell me, what is your ultimate purpose? Why you are creating these websites?
Website, that is to showcase, show to my customers, whoever wants to see my website or want to buy products from me.
So that means your ultimate goal is to reach out to customers, right? So
yes.
When you can reach out a customer only, then only there is some advantage of having this beautiful website.
Yes.
So now we just done with the designing process, that's it. So we haven't started any kind of marketing.
Yes.
So from here, your actual digital marketing is going to start. So till yesterday, we just concentrated on designing part. Why? Because we should have a one medium where we can promote the things. That's the reason we had that. So now
yes.
Our marketing is going to start. So our first way, so simply digital marketing means you already know it's a kind of using some digital tools and trying to market our product and services. So many alternative ways I'm going to choose and I'm going to reach out the customers where they are spending much of the time. So now, first digital tool or else first module or else first medium. So whatever you want, you can just call it. So it is what SEO. So SEO means search engine optimization. So before getting into this search engine optimization, let me clearly explain you what is this search engine. So do you know search engine?
Yes.
Google is a search engine.
Google is a search engine.
Bing.
Yahoo is a search engine. Bing is a search engine. Baidu is a search engine. So now tell me which search engine you use, Mansa? Which search engine you use?
Google.
Praveen, in your
Google.
Case? Funny,
Google.
In your case? Google. Sham,
Google.
Sam? So Sam also is Google. Everyone here uses the Google. Why? Why?
Like it's a flexible one.
It is easy. Yeah, it's flexible.
It is a flexible. And you know, so now we are an educated persons. So can you see that educated persons only looking out for the flexible things? How about the guys like our mother's generation and all? So do you think that they know this Yahoo, Bing, Baidu and all? Definitely no, right? So now everyone uses this Google. So Google is the best search engine we can use to find out the exact information that we want. So throughout the world, so Google has a highest ranking. So that's the reason. So I found this Google as a best medium to reach out my customers. Now let us say even a 10th class student also know this Google. Even an 8th class guy also know what is this Google. So if they want some information, they'll just open the Google Chrome and then they'll search it. Yes or no? So the same here, when I search for any keyword like how to prepare, how to prepare face mask at home. Okay, so now here you can see some results, right? Readerdigest.ca. And then here, if you can see, there are many websites. What are these results? These results are in the form of websites only, right? So if I click this, I'll be redirected to that website. If I click this, I'll be redirected to that particular website. So those are websites only. Now you have a website. You can make your website to show up like this. That is what simply SEO. Okay. Now let us say Manasa has started a business. So her business is all about like a... What is your business, Mansa? Let us say
beauty,
it's all about beauty blogs.
Yeah.
Okay. So she was trying to share her knowledge about face masks and hair tips and all. when someone searches like this, so I can see some results on top. Tell me which result will be having a more chance of getting clicks. The first one, right?
First one.
So obviously, as we are Indians, right, we will be having a bit patience. So we'll be going through the top 2, 3 or also. So top 10 sometimes. So have you ever been to second and third pages?
Yes,
sometimes, rare cases. Out of 100%, I'll give like a 2-3% for second and third pages. How about fourth and fifth pages?
Very rare.
So not even 1%. So maximum, so top 10 is the thing, that's it. So second pages and third pages is like a rare, and fourth, fifth, it's not even rare cases. So let's say your website is somewhere else in the 10th page. Will anyone visit your site now?
No way,
right? So no one knows whether you have a website or not, at least. Then what is the thing, you know, what is the use of having that beautiful website for you? So if no one is reaching out your website, is there any use now?
No.
Is there any use? No use, right?
No.
That's the reason I am doing this optimization. That is what simply search engine optimization. Okay, search engine optimization means choosing a search engine and trying to optimize. Now, so many crores of websites are having the content. So how Google is showing only few websites on top. So that means we have to impress Google to show up the websites on top. So, and again, it is not that easy. Why? Because we are not only in the market. Many people have started their business and they were doing SEO since 20 years and past 20 years. And now you just came and, you know, you started doing SEO and have to be on top. So it's not that easy. So we have to do. So SEO is, again, it's a consistent process. You have to do it. That's it. Okay. So there is no way of skipping this process if you want to drive some traffic. So now let us see. Now you came to know what is this search engine and how the results will appear. Okay. Now let me show you how this works. Now let's say if I search like this and Google was showing me these results. So these many results it was showing. So in just 0.77 seconds only. And when I search for one more thing, like, you know, how to wear mask. Can you see how many results it was showing? So this, it is showing the results in just 0.66 seconds. So why it is taking this here? Why is taking 0.77 seconds for this query? And why is taking 0.66 seconds for this query? So how exactly Google is going to retrieve the, how is it possible for the Google? So that all the things, let me show you now. Okay, so search engine works, Google, how Google works. So Google works in a 4 steps. First thing is that crawling. Second thing is that indexing. Third thing is that calculating relevancy. And third thing is that retrieving the data. First thing is that crawling. What is mean by crawling? Let me explain you with a simple diagram. Here a person okay, so here it's a searching. So a person is searching for a data. Let's say that www.digicodes.in. So for this website, he is searching. Okay, let's search you. Now, how Google works means there is a 4 process. First thing is that crawling. here there are many websites, right? So crawling means Google will visit each and every website that have a hosting. So the website which have hosted in a server, so each and every website Google will go. So this is what a crawling. So now let's say there are many websites like this situated in a server. So what Google will do now? Google will reach each and every website. Let us assume it's a Google. It will visit each and every site now. So after reaching, what it will do? It will collect the data. So that is what simply crawling. So first of all, Google will visit your site and it will collect the complete data of your website. It will collect whatever the images you have, whatever the content you have, whatever the video content, text content, audio files, whatever the thing you have, it is just going to collect. That process is called crawling. So this crawling is not directly done by a Google. So Google will send some robots. Okay, robots, them we call them as a spiders, we call them as a, you know, robots or bots. So we do call them different kinds of things. And this process is called spidering process, or else you can call it as a crawling. Okay, or spidering. Simply collecting the data. So let us assume these are the spiders. So these spiders go visit the websites and it will crawl the data. Okay, after crawling the data, what they will do? So they will index the complete data. Now, do you know library? Do you know like a dictionary? Let's say that if I told you to search a word meaning like a sophisticated, and I gave you dictionary. So how you'll search?
First go to S.
First go to S, then you go to SO, right?
Yeah.
So in such a way, you will just choose. Now you know the dictionary is indexed. Dictionary is formatted in such a way. Dictionary is structured in such a way so that it makes easier for a user to search for any kind of meaning, right? So that is the reason to make it easier for a Google to find out the information. This Google will index the complete data. Indexing means calculating, storing according to the category. So let me clearly explain you. Now, do you know the category? What is mean by categories in website? What is mean by categories in websites? Mm-hmm. So why do we create categories?
To post some data on daily basis.
So you will be segregating the data under some folder so that if someone click on that folder, they can see all relevant data. That is what here also. Indexing means segregating the data in a place so that Google easily can find out. So it is same like a library. So in library, we do have a segregation, like, so all social books are situated in one place. All, architecture books will be situated in one place and all science books will be, so that it is easier for us, right? So that's the reason Google will index the data. So how it will be like, let me show you one example. So now let's say that Manasa have a website on. So she wrote a blog on Sachin Tendulkar. Can you tell me under which category Google will store?
Sports.
So under sports also we do have some categories, right? Some subcategories like, indoor and outdoor. So can you tell me under which sub item my website stores?
Outdoor.
Okay. So under outdoor also, we may have a lot of sub items like what are the
cricket,
games?
Tennis.
Cricket, tennis,
badminton,
football. Okay.
Volleyball.
So few things, volleyball under.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Under outdoor, these are the sub items. So again, tell me under which sub item my website stores?
Cricket.
So again, for cricket also, many countries plays for cricket. Tell me.
India.
Next.
Pakistan.
Next.
West Indies. Australia. New Zealand, England.
New Zealand, yes. So these are the few countries. Then again, under India it's tours. So again, under India also, we do have many categories, like, you know, so we do have 11 cricket players who plays for India, right? So tell me the names.
Sachin, Dhoni,
Virat Kohli.
So I just mentioned the top three players. Okay, so what happens now under Sachin? Directly my website stores. So see the categorization under sport. This is just an example. So again, I'm not saying that this is how the indexing will be. So again, Google will be having n number of sub items like this. So under sports, indoor and outdoor. Under outdoor, again, I do have a cricket. Under cricket, I do have a India. Again, under India, so I have a many cricket players. And also again, under searching, so my blog will store. So in such a way, your website is stored under searching. When someone searches for a Sachin Tendulkar, so Google will get into the indexing part and Google will retrieve the data for the customer who is searching for. Okay, so now this is what indexing. Indexing means storing the data. Okay, so here it stores the data like a library. Okay. The next. Now tell me, will Manasa only the person who wrote a blog on Sachin Tendulkar? Is she the only one?
No,
right? So now here, when I search for any keyword like, you know, how to prepare a face mask at home, so I got a many results. That means many websites do have a topic on that. So then why Google was showing only this result on top? Why? That is what calculating relevancy. So now let's say here, Anusha and Swapna, my three. Okay. So three people wrote a blog on how to prepare a face mask at home. So then finally, Google will places my three website on top and the Swapna website in a second position and Anusha website in a third position. Why? Why? Because Google will calculate the relevancy. So which website have a more relevancy for the keyword that people are searching for? So Google will places that website on top. So again, how Google calculates that relevancy means we're gonna discuss that factors. So based on few factors, Google calculate the relevancy. Finally, Google decides that yes, this is the best website for the person who is searching for that query. So this website got crawled by Google. This website got indexed by Google. Finally, Google has calculated relevancy and Google found that this website is providing a very good information for this query. So this website is placed by a Google on top. This is the whole process done by Google. Again, how it is going to calculate the relevancy, that all the things we're going to discuss in later. This is what calculating relevancy. Calculating relevancy. Next. The next thing is that finally retrieving the data. Retrieving the data means now. So Google found that my three does have a very good information. What Google will do now? What Google will do?
Right, we'll retrieve the data.
So Google will places the my three website on top. Swapna website in a second position. Anusha website in a third position. Got it. So where it is showing the data? In SERP. So SERP means search engine results page. So what does it mean? Search result page. Now can you see the results here? Yeah. So now this is a search engine and I can see a results in one page. This is called search engine results page. Okay, whatever the results you are right away seeing, and this is a page, right? And two, it is a search engine. That is what I am calling it as a search engine results page. Okay, so again, the structure of a search in the structure of SERP depends on the query. Now, when I search for how to prepare a face mask, it was showing me some image box. Okay. So when I search for how to wear a mask, it was showing me some videos. When I search for any kind of laptops, it was showing me some ads on top. When I search for online digital marketing training, so it is showing me some ads. When I search for COVID vaccine, so what it is showing you? What it is showing you?
Videos.
News articles. So news box. It is a news box. So in such a way, so if anyone, if an interviewer asks you that what is the structure of SCRP, tell them that structure of SCRP depends. So it varies according to the query. So it can be like images. It can be like a normal results like websites. It can be like a news. It can be like a YouTube videos. It can be like a people also ask. Have you ever noticed? People also ask. See now, do we have this kind of thing? What is this? People also ask, right? So sometimes it will show people also ask. Sometimes it will show some kind of structured snippet also it shows. In such a way, structure of SCRP depends on a query of the particular person searches for. So now if you go and search for laptop, it was showing you some ads. Okay, so it can show some ads, it can show some news, it can show some videos, it can show some images, it can show some kind of structure snippets and all. So this is the structure of SCRP, just remember. Okay, now in such a way, your website will appear after
can
calculating
repeat
the relevance.
Repeat once again, Chitra.
Okay, so would you like to write? Note it down?
Yeah, I'll.
Yes, so sometimes it shows you the image box. Sometimes it will show you the normal results. Sometimes it shows you the news box. It shows you the YouTube videos. It shows you people also ask. It shows you ads. Okay, so anyhow, I wrote here. I'm going to share it this notepad. Okay. Okay, so finally, this is the process. First thing is to crawl. The next thing is to index. Then third thing is to finding out the relevancy of the websites. Then finally, retrieving the data, means showing the data in Google. Okay, so crawling means, tell me.
Collecting the data
from websites. So after collecting, what it will do?
It will categorize.
Yeah, segregate. Okay, so it will segregate under appropriate category. Okay. Next, calculating relevancy. That means
finding the best website,
which is more relevant for the query. Finding the best website. Then retrieving the data in SCRP means?
Showing the results.
Yeah. Yes. Showing the results in SCRP. Again, do you remember what is mean by SCRP?
Yeah, search engine results page.
Okay. Now you know how this Google works, simply how a search engine works. Finally, what are the factors that Google is going to consider for calculate the relevancy? Factors that Google considers. First thing is that on-page optimization. Then second thing is that off-page optimization. And third thing is that server-side optimization. Okay. So Google will find out how well you have done your on-page optimization and how well you have done off-page and how well you have done the server side. So if everything is fine with your website, like on-page, off-page and server side, so and it calculates how effectively you are doing, so finally that website is going to place on top. That's it. So what are these factors and how exactly we're gonna do, so that all the things we're gonna see is in a later sessions. Okay. So the next thing is that, so I'm getting some disturbance, guys. So there are two techniques, SEO techniques. So first thing is that white hat technique and black hat technique. So the name implies only, the name itself implies one thing is a good and other thing is a bad one. So white hat technique. White hat technique means, so whatever the Google privacy and policy, whatever the Google terms and conditions are there, I am going to perform according to that terms and conditions. I'm not at all violating any terms and conditions of a Google. So according to the Google, I'm just working to be on top. So I'm just optimizing my website in a right way, so without violating any terms and conditions. So what white hat means, simply your on page, off page and server side. If you do all these things perfectly, then it will be white hat. Then black hat means, so following some malpractices. Now let's say Praveen is it. So Praveen wants to show up his website on top. That's it. He doesn't care from the Google's perspective, and he doesn't care from the user's perspective. Just he wants to drive some traffic. That's it. He started doing some malpractices just to be on top. He's not at all, he don't have any intention of providing some good information for users. So he just trying to be on top. That is what simply malpractices. So what are the few malpractices that people use to follow just to be on top, to drive a traffic? Let me just show you now. So first thing is that keyword stuffing. Keyword stuffing. And second thing is called changing the font color to a background color. Background color. And then third thing is called redirections. And then fourth thing is called doorway pages. Call it as a cloaking also. So what does it mean? Keyword stuffing, changing the font color, and then cloaking and doorway pages. Let me show you now. Now here Praveen. So Praveen started writing a blog on Sachin Tendulkar. So earlier, how Google used to work, Google used to find out the website, as a most relevancy, which have a most number of keywords. Now let's say if Praveen is there. Praveen had a blog on Sachin Tendulkar. He just wrote a keywords. That's it. Sachin Tendulkar. So same. He's just repeating this keyword, that's it. Searching. Okay, so whereas what happens with the Google, so when the Google, when from Google's perspective, it's a Google and it's a user. From the Google perspective, so Google visits this website to crawl the data. So finally, Google will think that, acha, this person has a repeated keyword. So maybe this person is famous for the query who searches for Sachin Tendulkar. So that is what Google. So Google is not a human being to understand the meaning of the content. So it works according to the algorithms it has set up. That's it. So now when Google uses, Google found that Acha, this person repeated the keyword many times. So maybe this person is very famous. Maybe this person have a more information for the person who is searching for a Sachin Tendulkar keyword. That's the reason Google started making these websites on top earlier. Okay. So that's the reason Praveen, what Praveen has done. So Praveen started doing this malpractice just by stuffing the keywords. That's it. He's not at all giving some good information. Whereas when user visits your site, will he satisfy now?
No.
When user visits, definitely no, right? So now if I'm searching for any query on Google and if I find a website which consists of only keywords, so is there any use now for me? No use, right?
No.
Definitely what happened, it's a user's bad experience now. So user is facing some bad experience as because you're being on top and no good information in your website. So definitely it's a bad experience. For whom the Google is working? So is it for a website owners? So Google is working for the users. Okay. So it is not for the website owner who wants to make some money. No. So that's the reason. So Google has overcome this process. Google started recognizing these kind of malpractices. So that is keyword stuffing. A person, whoever do this keyword stuffing, so Google is going to punish these kind of websites. Okay. So punishing means it don't have a right to delete the websites or not. So it will reduces the rankings of this website. Simply, it would never ever makes these kinds of websites on top. So that's the reason keyword stuffing is the malpractices you should never perform for your website. So because you should know, right, what to perform and what not to perform. If you know what to perform, you should know what not to perform also. Then only you can do SEO well. So the next thing is changing the font color to a background color.
But you said that, you know, Google just go as per the algorithm. So how will they identify?
So Google updated. Google updated. Now in 1980s, Google was not like a 1980s now. So it updated many things, many things. So that is what algorithm. So Google has been updating the algorithms and that updates are going to hit your website whenever it's get updated. Okay. So now why people will say digital marketing is not a constant thing like a maths and all. So it is going on updating. So SEO, now SEO is, this is what right now. So it might update in future. So if you are going to learn a digital marketing, you should habituate to update yourself. Okay. So why? Because Google. Now futures also, can you see app futures? Is it going to be same every year? All right, it's get updated. The same way Google also gets updated for giving a better and better information for the user. Okay, so even earlier we have only LCD TVs and also now we have a LED TV and now we have a smart Android TVs. It's getting updated according to the user's experience. So for making easier for the users, so everything is getting updated. Okay, so for users only, digital marketing is updating simply. Okay. Now, one more process also people used to follow. So that means, what is it? Instead of creating a one page, people used to divide the page into two sections. So in the bottom section, they used to write a content. It's fine. It's a normal average one. Not that so good again. So on top section, again, they started stuffing the keywords. So this time what they have done is they changed this top section font color to a background color. So now what is my background color?
White.
Now if I make this text into white, can human being detect this?
No.
All right. Okay. So whereas from Google's perspective, can Google find it?
I think so.
Google is a machine, no? Google can find it. Okay. So whereas users, can they find?
No.
So now top section is not visible for them. So directly they'll start reading from here. So whereas here when Google visits, Google finds that acha, this website has a good number of keywords repeated. So maybe this website is famous for the keyword search engine. This website, it is used to make these kinds of websites on top. Whereas from the user's perspective, so it is providing a good information for the user. So here this person, Praveen, is cheating both Google as well as the user. For what? For just to be on top, right? So that's the reason. This is also one malpractices. Now, if you are writing some content memes, never ever try to change the font color to a background color. So what Google will think? Google will think that you are trying to hide some information. It is not at all a good. You can change the font color, no problem, but never ever change the font color to a background color. So again, it's a blunder mistake. So this is also one malpractice. The next thing is that cloaking. So cloaking means, so now instead of having a one page, they created a two pages. So one is for Google, one is for user. Okay, so for Google, they will show good information to be on top. Okay, for users, they will show some bad information, so bad content. Have you ever noticed that once you clicked on that URL, you have faced many other irrelevant information?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes, right. We do face normally. So that is what kind of cloaking. So now just to impress the Google.
Cloaking?
Cloaking. Yes. So showing one content to the user and showing one other content for the Google. This is what a cloaking. Okay. So again, it is also a malpractices. Don't do these kind of things.
Cloaking, C-L-O-G-I-N-G.
C-L, no, cloaking. This is.
Okay.
The next thing is the doorway pages. Now let's say this is an SERP. What I'll do, I'll create a different pages. Okay. So my four results will be like a top four results, you know, in SERP. There are four results and top four results are my website only. You might have faced these issues also. This is my website. A person who is searching for one query, he clicked on first result. After clicking first result, he been to the same, this website. After clicking on the second result also, he been to the same website. After clicking the third result also, he been to same website and fourth. In such a way, you are redirecting the customers to a same page whenever they click on the results. So again, it is like, you know, you are trying to create a different URL for the same content. Got it? So that means you are trying to drive a more and more traffic here. A person who clicked the first result and if he is not satisfied with the second result, and why he wants to be go to the same page, do you think? So he is not satisfied with the first result and he might be expecting something with the second result. And when I click the second result also, I've been to the same website. Is that good again?
No.
Yes, of course you are driving a traffic, but here from the Google's perspective, so it is not at all a good one. So this is called a doorway page. Have you ever noticed these kind of things in SERP? Clicked on many results and been to the same website?
Yes,
we do normally. Yes. So this is called a doorway pages. So these are the few black hat techniques that Google have found that many people were doing. So if you now, you know that these are the malpractices. If you start doing these malpractices, then Google is going to hit your website. So hit means it just punishes. Punishes means it is going to reduce the rankings of your website. Okay. So now, apart from these four black hat techniques, we do have a one more technique that is called duplication. So never ever copy the content from other website to your website. Now let's say here, Anusha, Swapna and then Maitri. Three websites have the same content. Let's say that Swapna has copied the content from Maitri and Anusha has copied the content from Maitri. So that means three websites have the same content. Can you tell me how Google can decide which website is a good one? So definitely Google has to show one website on top, right? It can't show all websites on top. Is it possible? Is it possible to show all websites on first yes. place?
Yes, yes.
No, right? That's the reason it has to show only one website on top. Then how Google can decide which website is a good one and bad one if everyone have the same content?
The first blogger, first one who has wrote the blog. After the date and time, they might list on the top.
Again, so anything else?
Keywords.
So here what happens, this is also one more reason now. So if Google allows in such a way, definitely the person who copied will be in a second position, right? Definitely a person who copied, second time, he will be in a third position. In such a way, that means Google is allowing the copy content. Is that? So no. So never ever copy the content from any other website. So it is a main malpractices you should never perform for your website. So whatever it might be, whether you have some grammatical errors, so if you have some issues with the structure of a content also, never mind. Try to write your own content. Okay, so whatever it might be like, if you have some grammatical errors also, no problem. So maintain your own content. So it gives the best result rather than copying the content from other websites. So this is also one more thing you have to remember. So now, till now I'm saying that yes, Google is going to punish your website. So who exactly punishing your website? So not directly Google. So now here crawling is done by who? Directly Google?
No, bots.
So bots will crawl. So here also Google don't punish your websites. Google have some algorithms. That is called Google algorithms. So, or we can call them as updates also. The first thing is that Panda update. Second thing is called Penguin update. Third thing is Speech update. Fourth thing is Hummingbird update. EMD update. Mobile friendly update. Okay. So normally we do call them as a Google algorithms, and these algorithms will update frequently. Okay. So Panda algorithm update frequently, Penguin algorithm update frequently. So we can call them as updates or algorithms, no problem. So if an interviewer asks you about, so what are the updates? Okay, you have to tell them that. So we have a few algorithms like Panda and PageGen and all. So they do update frequently. That is called updation. So now let me show you what exactly it is. Panda update means whatever the malpractices till now we have seen. So duplication, keyword stuffing and all. So if you do all those things, this update is going to hit your website. So for every 3 months, so I can't say that exact, it can be like a 3 months. It can be like a 1 month. It can be like a 1.5 months. For every 1 to 2 months or 6 months, it's get updated. Once it get updated, so it is going to hit all the websites, whoever have some duplicate content, some malpractices. So next, Penguin update. If your website have a spammy backlinks or else, it can be like a backlinks topics we haven't discussed yet. So this backlinks topic we're gonna see in off-page optimization. As of now, just remember that this update is going to hit the websites which are having some spammy backlinks. The next thing is that PageGen update is not any kind of punishable update. It is going to give a priority for the local listings. So now, okay, open your browser and search for digital marketing training. So don't mention any kinds of location. Just open your browser and search for digital marketing training. That's it. And tell me what you can see. Do it fast. Google is giving a priority for the local listing. That happens with this PGN update. Okay, again, it's not any kind of punishable update. You don't need to worry. So it's get updated frequently so that you can see the local listings. The next thing is Hummingbird update. Hummingbird update means in 1980s, when Google was invented? When? Anyone knows? Here, Vinay? Don't browse now, okay?
I don't know, Chitra.
Okay, at least browse and tell me. Kind of query like a Sachin Tendulkar. So let me search for what is that? Sachin Tendulkar? No. Recently, who got married? That Nitin, right?
Yeah.
Nitin marriage. Okay. So it is showing me some news. What exactly that Google is finding is Google is trying to find out the intention of the user who is searching for. So now it is showing me exactly the Nitin marriage photos, Nitin marriage news and right. So is it showing me anything like a Nitin career, Nitin movies and all? Tell me.
No,
right? So how Google is coming to know what exactly we are searching for? Earlier when we used to search for these kind of queries, Google used to show complete information about Nitin. So not a specific thing. Why? Because Google was not updated at the time. So now Google was trying to give exact, precise and exact information that is done with the help of this Hummingbird update, Hummingbird algorithm. So it gives a precise and exact results. Okay. This is one update. Then EMD update. EMD update means simply exact match domain. So exact match domain means, so what is mean by domain? Tell me.
Website name.
Website name. www.
ODMT.
Okay, I'll take this. Okay, now I have taken this website www.nitinmarriage.com. When I search for nitinmarriage.com, sorry, not .com, just a word like a Nitin marriage, who will be coming on top? Two websites, nitinmarriage.com, maitri.com. So maitri.com is Maitri's website, nitinmarriage.com is my website. When someone searches for nitinmarriage.com, Maitri also does have a information about Nitin's marriage. So now whose website is coming on top?
Your website.
Why?
Because the name exactly matches with the content.
So why it has to match with the domain? So it has to find out the website who have some good information, no? So why it is going with a Nitin marriage?
So the specific words, whatever you have searched, there is a website completely on that name. That's why maybe.
See now. No? Did I search for a website?
No,
I searched with a word, simply the ODMT, that's it. So I didn't search for any kinds of website general. So what it is showing me? ODMT.in website it is showing me. So now do remember once again that Google will check. Google will try to match the query with the domain. So Google will think that acha, this person may be searching for a website. So that's the reason Google will show this website on top. So though he have a good information or not, so he is just going with that website. So what happens now? This person purchased the domain and then he is just being on top without doing any kinds of SEO simply. So why can't others do that one? So everyone will go with these kinds of domains and everyone will try to be on top. So again, this is also one kind of malpractices. So your domain should not match with a keyword actually. Now, my domain, my website is like a dizzycourse.in. So instead of going with the dizzycourse.in, I can go with the digital marketing training institute in hyderabad.com, right? So instead of striving hard, doing optimization and all, I can just go and purchase that domain, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
So you should not do this. Do remember again. So it has to be simple and short again. Right, this is so, one so more update.
So you mean to say in this Nitin and Maitri, so Maitri will be on the top listing, not the Nitin Marriage.
Nitin Marriage will be on top. That's the reason what happens. Though Maitri have a good content also, this NitinMarriage.com is being on top. So here, is that good again?
No, but Nitin Marriage itself is the exact match what you have searched for. Right?
Exact match, yes. But it don't have any content. When user comes to this website, he's not providing any good information. He just want to drive some traffic and so that he can earn money. So what happens here? So do you think is it concentrating on quality? Sorry?
No, isn't it a malpractice? That's what I'm asking.
It is a malpractice, yes. EMD update is a algorithm. It is going to hit the website whoever has a domain exactly matching with the keyword. Okay. Amazon is there. Instead of going with the Amazon.com, it can go like a laptops.com. It can go like a shoes.com, hairclips.com. So in such a way, it can take, right? Why it has gone with Amazon.com? Got it?
Yeah.
So that's the reason you have to keep in mind this EMD also. Then mobile friendly update again. So your website has to be a mobile friendly. So it has to be flexible for the mobile also. Why? Because your visitors will be like from mobile phone only. So you have to make sure that your website is flexible in mobile also. This is also one kind of algorithm. If your website is not a mobile friendly, then this update is going to hit your website. So these are the few algorithms you have to keep in mind.